into your life. There's no turning back, even while we sleep. We will find you acting on your best behavior. Turn your back on Mother Nature. Everybody wants to
BC. We're at Outfitters Camp and we're just about to head into the mountains for our first stone sheep hunt. Pretty good weather today. It's pretty hot here as well. So packed up all our gear. We're gonna shoot across the river here then up into these mountains, and we're gonna backpack. We're not using horses this year, so it's gonna be tough work. But hopefully we will be rewarded with a beautiful stone sheep ram. So, fingers crossed.
So we just made it out of the main basin here and come up out of the willows, and we're just been glassing this main basin around us, and just about to move off. We had a group of ewes and lambs pop out over the rise just behind us, so that was a cool little opportunity to get a bit of film and have a look at what they do. Hoping they're going to be a band of big old ugly rams, but unfortunately, you're just going to head up behind me.
Well, I can't really believe our luck today. We've been out in the mountain all day today, and our clients were up in front of us. Rick and Spencer, and me and Scott were maybe 50 metres behind them coming up the hill. All of a sudden, they're pointing their sticks and waving around, and me and Scott thought a great big ram was going to jump out in front of us, but sure enough, Wolverine just comes flying right at us and misses us by about 30 or 40 metres. Got a little bit of footage of him, and then we've just been sitting up here on the top of the hill and we've seen two marmots. So, doesn't get any better than that. They're cool little creatures, those marmots. They're flicking their tails around and eating grubs and things like that, so it's pretty cool. They're all laughing at me here. I'm doing a bit of a selfie, so I'll put them on TV. So from camp, we just walked up this valley here and we're just coming out of the tree line, and Scott spotted four rams.
He was furthest away. He was feeding through all the brush. And he's right on that point of being legal, so we're pretty confident he is. And the other ram, big ram that was there, has bedded down, so we can't really have a good look at him. He's looking straight at us, so we need a side shot of him just to see if he's bridging the nose. They're a bit too far to age yet, so we're just gonna sit here, hold tight, and see where they move to.
Another great day on the mountain and another opportunity for me to talk to myself, so thought I'd give you a quick little update on the hunt. Two of the rams went off in their own direction, and then the biggest two, one I named Bruiser, big old broomed off ram, him and the other big boy, they stayed behind and unfortunately, didn't get to a spot where we could shoot them from, so have to see what tomorrow brings. We've been sitting here for the past 6 days, basically. Looking at Bruiser and his mates feeding away on this hillside.
They're almost going out of sight right here, so we'll be able to see better from up top, and then if they are going to cross, we should be a step ahead so that we can maybe make a move if they're coming our way.
Alright.
We've just left our glassing spot where we're sitting on those four rams, and the wind's been really bad there, so they're not in the best spot to put on a final stalk. So the plan now is to head around the back side of the mountain that they're on, and hopefully sit there for a couple of hours and watch them come around. But it's getting late in the day, so yeah, we're just gonna have to hope like hell they do come around there. There's one nice legal ram out of the four, but yeah, it's gonna be a waiting game. See how this wind keeps up and go from there.
Or maybe people are jerks.
Last night we sat on those four rams, one legal ram, and
They showed themselves around the mountain, but just too far away. An open country for us to get in close, and they didn't really come around the hill where we wanted them to. So that's how it goes. It's hunting for you. Doesn't always work out, but I've got to go back to Windy Point and close that camp down. Got to drain all the water lines of water so they don't freeze over in winter and crack. Move generators into the shed, or little jobs like that. Then the neighbouring outfitter, he's going to fly in on his float plane, land on the river. That'll be a pretty awesome experience. He's going to pick me up and take me over to our other camp, Burnt Rose, and I'm going to open that up by myself. So that'll be pretty cool. A little bit excited about going in a float plane. I've never been in one before, and should be a bit of fun.